Today was my first day at the colliery. Early in the morning, I met John, a collier, by the pit head wheel, and we headed to the entrance. We came to a rope which would carry us to the bottom of the pit. We stepped into the cage. The signal sounded, and with a jerk and a rattle, we started heading down into the dark. When we arrived at the bottom of the shaft, John passed me a safety lamp and told me to let him know if the flame turned blue. A blue flame means gas, which can be very dangerous in a mine. We journeyed for about half a mile into the mine. I carefully picked my way along the cramped tunnels, noticing how warm it was compared to the crisp, frosty morning air we had left behind up at the surface. In the distance, we saw the glimmering of a candle, which was stuck in a miner's cap. The cap belonged to a giant of a man. He was using a pick to smash coal out of the wall. John shouted out to the man, who was called George, and he turned with a beaming grin on his face. Stepping forward, he passed me the pick and told me to have a go. I was not strong enough to break much coal from the coal face, but that would not be my job. I would be working as a loader, filling the tubs that would attach to the trams with coal. We were soon joined by more loaders, and with the help of my new workmate, we set to work collecting the coal. The work was hard, and my lungs felt heavy with the thick dust that filled the warm, damp air. We stopped to eat lunch, and they shared with me a can of cold coffee and Tommy, as they call their bread and cheese. One of the boys explained to me that during the winter months, we would not see sunlight apart from one day a week, Sunday. It was dark when we got to work at 6 in the morning. It would be going dark when we came out of the pit at 4 in the afternoon. I feel like it will take a long time to get used to living in darkness. On that thought, we returned to the coal face to work hard for the rest of the day. It's a little before 4, bones aching and muscles screaming. We started on the journey back to the surface. At one point, we had to squeeze ourselves against the rock to allow a train of empty trams to pass. The driver stopped briefly to chat while I admired his horse. We eventually reached the bottom of the shaft, and I happily returned to the fresh air above. The miner's life is very difficult and risky. The conditions are damp, dark and dirty. Men get black lung and die. The risk of explosions, flooding and collapse makes it dangerous work. Working as part of a team is the only good that I can see in this situation. The pay, at 20 shillings a week, is only just enough to survive on. I will return to work tomorrow, looking forward to seeing my new friends, but also well aware of how hard the day's work will be.